हरे कृष्णा, श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय। वेलकम टू बद्रिका आश्रम ऑनलाइन कोर्सेज। इन दिस कोर्स वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग ऑन विमेन इन स्पिरिचुअलिटी। नाउ यू मस्ट बी थिंकिंग व्हाई वी हैव चोजन विमेन इन स्पिरिचुअलिटी, दिस टॉपिक व्हाई वी हैव चोजन। वेल, श्रील रूपा गोस्वामी सेज इन नेक्टर ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शन दैट फॉर सक्सेस इन डिवोशन, इन डिवोशनल सर्विस, देर आर सिक्स थिंग्स विच वी नीड टू फॉलो। द फर्स्ट थिंग इज दैट वी शुड हैव एंथुजियाज्म। नंबर सेकेंड इज डिटर्मिनेशन। Third is we should have patience, we should be following rules and regulations, and we should not take association of non-devotees, and we should be following footsteps of acharyas, previous acharyas. So what does that mean to follow footsteps of acharyas? Well, that means that we need to read, we need to contemplate on the life histories of these acharyas, and then we will come to know that how they did devotion. They must also have faced some hurdles, some challenges, but how they could overcome. Once we read their life histories, we will come to know, and that will help us in doing our devotion as well. So that is the reason that this particular reference has been given, that life history of acharyas needs to be studied. Then this spirituality, what is spirituality? Spirituality actually, it's a quest of mankind since time immemorial. Many saints, many sages, they have come and walked on this path, and everybody gave one single message, and that is service, service to the mankind. What kind of service? It should be selfless service, which we need to do. Selfless service. There should be not even an iota of selfishness when we are serving that Supreme Personality of Godhead. Everything has to be for Him only. Now, it's like, you know, there are many references which are given regarding this service attitude. In introduction of this Bhagavad Gita also, Srila Prabhupada mentions that this serving, that is the service, it's the main thing for a living being. Why it's main thing? Because it's this Sanatan Dharam, it's the eternal religion for living beings. Even once Sanatan Goswami, he asked Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that what is the constitutional position of living being. So Mahaprabhu said, well, there is the only one constitutional position of the living being is service. That is the only thing what human, what a living being need to do, that is service to the Supreme Lord. So then Srila Prabhupada has mentioned in there that like the man, he serves his wife, a mother serves her children, father serves her mother. So it's equally one or the other serves some person or the other person. So service is the main thing. So we mothers, why we should remain behind? As such, we are the caretakers of the home. So we are the first person, we are the first guru of our children. So we need to put them on this right path. But that will happen only when we are charged, when we are on this path, then only we can inculcate these values in our children and bring them on this path. Otherwise, it's not possible for the children to come on this path. Even Srila Prabhupada has mentioned that if somebody does not serve Supreme Personality, it's a pain to Supreme Personality. He feels that pain when we don't serve Him. It's like exactly, he gives the example of the body, like the all the limbs of the body, they serve the body, but whichever limb does not serve the body, it pains. So same is the case with the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So we have to serve, and we need to inculcate these good things, and we need to be we need to have our children on this path right from the beginning itself, because that will make the foundation strong. And we can see, like even in Bhagavatam, there is an example of Dhruv Maharaj. Dhruv Maharaj, who inspired Dhruv Maharaj for this? It was her. It was his mother only. And we can see even in this Markandeya Puran, there is a story of Madalasa, how she basically inculcated those habits in her children. Her three sons became monks. And then there is a description even in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad with this Maitri having a discussion with her husband, that is Yagavalka. So Yagavalka was ready to give her all the possessions, but Maitri asked him, if these possessions are going, they are not going to help me in getting liberated, what I am going to do with this? So she also left that, and she also went for this higher purpose. And one more thing is that it's not necessary that everybody is able to do walk on this path smoothly. There will be definitely hurdles, and But what we need to do, we have to overcome these hurdles, but we need to be enthusiastic for that. So these women, they will not, every woman will not have the same same kind of struggle. Everybody will have their own different struggles. I'm myself a woman, I also have my own struggles, but because of the these my guru and Vaishnavas, their blessings, their mercy, I'm able to move on this path. And now another thing what we have done is we have covered women from various traditions. Well, the reason for that is, as Bhaktivinoda Thakur always used to say, that we need to be saragrahi, not what do we mean by saragrahi? Saragrahi means that who takes the essence from everything. And he used to say, take essence from everything, and the externals can be left as such. So we have to be charged. We have to take this responsibility of walking on this path in spite of the difficulties whichever we will be having. So I bow to all these women who have been on this path and who are basically an inspiration for us. Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada ki jai.